Hippocrates told his students that you should always, particularly when diagnostic methods were not very advanced, smell the presence of disease on breath. It really took off quantitatively with a Nobel laureate, Linus Pauling, doing measurements of the substances which emerge from breath. And since then, some 1,000 compounds have been found in the breath of various human beings, and a typical human will have 400 different materials coming out on their breath, often at levels which are exceptionally low. Physiologists had a problem. They wanted to learn directly how the human body uses oxygen, what the rates of consumption are, and how these change with particular conditions.
As the volunteer breathes in and out through the device, you will see changing composition of the oxygen, carbon dioxide, and water concentration within the airways on a real-time basis. And the core of this device is that it will combine these simultaneous measurements and produce an estimate of the oxygen uptake and CO2 production on a breath-by-breath basis. And this is something quite challenging to achieve, and which is not currently done during surgery. So the idea is that this could bring a huge amount of information to clinicians and help, particularly in cases where you need to provide, for example, 100% of oxygen to resuscitate a patient which had cardiac arrest.
Thinking, can we make some commercial activity out of this? That's how the spin-out company formed and eventually became Oxford Medical Diagnostics. And the major target of that has been in the detection of the molecule acetone. Acetone is a molecule which has long been associated with diabetes, and particularly so when a diabetic is essentially out of control, when the insulin therapy is not working or the person doesn't know that they've got diabetes, happens in young children, and the body accumulates a chemical, those are ketones, and these chemicals break down to produce acetone on the breath.
What we do is we get the user to hold their breath for 3 seconds and then just breathe out fully into a breath bag. We then take that bag, attach it to the device. The device has got a pump in it. This draws the breath through into the sampling chamber. We measure the amount of light that is absorbed by the breath sample. This is measured by a detector. And then this outputs a reading of the amount of acetone in that person's breath in parts per million. We're also hoping that we can use this breath acetone measurement to hopefully one day provide a way of non-invasively measuring blood glucose. Particularly for young children, measuring your blood glucose involves taking a finger prick test, and this can be quite uncomfortable and distressing.
The things that's happened with the small impact program that we've been funded for now is that well, we've set up exercise testing routines, we've got some data, we haven't finished this yet. Will it be of any use? I don't know. Will the impact with our breath analyzer for anesthesia be of any use? I can say for that, it looks as if it will. It looks as if we are going to have some real use for it within the medical profession. We have champions who are willing to put this into operating theatres, and we hope into intensive care units.